Hello YouTube, my name is J-War and this will be my first video. It's more of a knife review, so this is for all you knife nuts out there. This is kind of more of a discovery. This is a knife review featuring Bastinelli Creations and Bastinelli knives. Okay, not for the corny ass intro, but first up, we got, let's do the neck knives first. We have the Moon's Kiss, which is the mid-tech. Yes, this is water jet cut, and this is the RWL 34 steel. Fits great in the hand. It's a chisel grind with a mirror finish. It's got this is a version 2, I believe. It's got the jimping right on top here, and more jimping here for the controlled cutting. Thing is awesome. Super sharp. Came super sharp. Stropped a little bit to get it even sharper. Thing cuts right through, glides through paper. Apparently my cutting test skills aren't so great, but yep, it pops paracord. Well, not at this angle, but as you can see, like butter. Mirror finish comes with the paracord wrapping. I believe you have options just to get it without, and some of the options you get the little skull bead in the middle here. Like I said, man, great ergos, retails for about $80. You can find it in a couple French websites, but a lot of these knives are kind of hard to come by just because the maker, Bastion Coves, is based out of France. Do visit his website though, BastinelliCreations.com. Awesome stuff. But this is the Moon's Kiss. Also great in a reverse grip. Great for self-defense. Great Kydex sheath for it. Also, I'm going to add here, he makes these adjustable too with a very simple slip knot. Great for the neck. If you want to hang it down or if you want it tight up against the neck. But great little knife. Okay, that is the Moon's Kiss. See, also here in my collection, I have the Micro Lacal Micro Paracord Wrap. The wrap on here is awesome. Nice and thick, too. I got a real good grip on it. No jimping, but I don't think you need it with this knife. This knife is pretty secure here with this half a choil. Great little razor blade, controlled cut, great for carving, wood carving, get different grips on it. You can almost hold the whole thing here if you got to slice something like this for whittling. Nice little lanyard on it. Nice in the reverse grip. Put your finger through here so you don't lose it. Great little self-defense necker. I think I paid a little too much for it, but it was worth it. It was about $155. I bought it secondhand. This one was at the Blade Show. But these things are great. Virtually no secondary bevel on it. Makes it ultra sharp for its cutting geometry. Man, this thing just, it rips through paracord, rips through paper. I wish I had a itty bitty tiny water bottle. I could probably cut through it, but this thing just pops paracord. You could probably push cut just about anything with it. But yeah, severs it cleanly. Like I said, great little necker. Great little necker. Yeah, moving on. Great design too. Moving on. Well, this also comes with a little tiny sheath too. It's rather stylish, in my opinion. But this also has the slip knot as well. Next up, we have the Bastinelli Creations. I believe this SK here is for Survival Knife Limited. A guy named Mansoor from London. I did believe he's on the forums, or the British forums at least. I bought this knife off of Blade HQ. Oh, I forgot to mention this is D2 as well. This one is D2. RWL34. This one is D2. This is a friction folder, orange G10. Nice mirror polish, textured flats on it, jimping right here. Feels great in the hand. Definitely a nice little toy, nice little treat. This one retails. I bought this one on Blade HQ for $275. Well worth it. It's got the Warncliffe design here. Super sharp. Not as sharp as the this guy here, the Micro Cal, but very sharp. It doesn't necessarily pop paracord, but it will glide through paper. Great for self-defense. Nice thing about these friction folders here, they have this the pry bar here. You could really hurt somebody with that if you needed to, but I guess it's more of a non-lethal way to strike somebody with a knife if need be. Great little knife. Craftsmanship, the fit and finish on these things are absolutely amazing, especially for the price point. I mean, a custom knife for under $300, well worth it. If you ever get a chance, pick any or see a Bastinelli Creations knife, get it. You won't be disappointed. And last up, I have the Dragotech Compact Friction Folder. This is D2 steel as well. It's nice, beefy G10 scales here, which might I add, it's textured. He did put all the file work into this just for your grip. This thing contours to your hand like nobody's business. I mean, concealable, if you really wanted to, you could hold it in your hand like this, and virtually it's gone. Give somebody a thumbs up or whatever. But you can, it's supposed to be a two-handed opening, but if you can put your finger over the pry bar, you can open it generally pretty quickly and easily. Look at the file work on here too. File work to flats. This thing by far is the sharpest knife I own. And this thing really is no joke. Bastion Coves, the maker, he does a lot of cut tests on his YouTube channel. That's Basta. Well, BAST2A. Bast2A. But, he does one where he pretty much just cuts a hanging rope. That's pretty damn hard to do, in my opinion. If I had some more room, I'd probably show you with the paracord, but I can pretty much chop through this paracord while it's hanging. I mean, we could give it a shot here. Doubt it's gonna work, but you know. Almost. Well, that's barely with any force. Paracord's a little short. I'm a little weary about cutting it, so maybe I'll do another video with just the cut test to show you. But it pops paracord. And this is, I didn't even strap it or anything. There is basically no secondary bevel on this thing. It is just one piece of metal, pretty much right from the edge straight to the flat. The geometry on this thing is awesome. And put the little paracord on here. What else? This is a little black backspacer with the red liners. It's kind of a signature of his, I believe, the black and the red. Or black and blood, I should say. I did get on the internet and emailed them. I sent off for an order. I'm getting the Dragotac Large. I think is more of a 3.5-inch blade, somewhere around there. But getting the large and the BB, which is a little friction folder which you can hang around your neck. I'm sure some of you guys have seen it, but they are hard to come by. Yeah, pretty much send him about $600 for the large one, and for the BB. Should be seeing them around February. So keep your eyes peeled for another video. I probably will do a review about those too. Yeah, also, other news, he has the BBR2 coming out. I don't know if you guys know or have seen the BBR1, but and I believe he made 75 of the BBR1. I'm not sure how many of the BBR2s he's going to make, but I believe if you contact him, you can put a reserve on one. And I believe those are coming out December or January. Great folder. Great folder. I don't have anything negative to say about any of his knives. Like I said, if you see one, pick one up. And that's it for this video. I will, like I said, review the next knives I get from him. And everybody be well and toodles.